French Riviera provides the backdrop as the world's most beautiful feminine bodies take center stage. It's head-to-head competition as they display their form and physique at the IFBB Women's World Bodybuilding Championship.
Everybody, I'm Ahmad Rashad, along with four-time Miss Olympia Corey Everson, and we are here in the beautiful south of France for the
1988 IFBB Women's World Professional Bodybuilding Championships.
You're talking about a sport that is really growing rapidly. This is one.
This has grown tremendously in the past few years. In fact, this contest today has got 27 competitors from all over the world. In fact, it's the largest field of competitors women's bodybuilding has ever had.
You know, being around watching these ladies work out, not eating, and then us going out eating, not working out, don't you feel a little guilty?
A little bit. Maybe we should run over to the hall and work off some of this extra food we've had.
Maybe we should run over to the hall.
Especially you, right?
Okay, all right, okay. Ready, go. Okay.
Coming up, our first competitor, France's own Dominique Dardet.
Well, Corey, we finally made it over to the beautiful Acropolis Auditorium here in Nice, France, and we're moments away from the competition. But now one thing, Bev Francis, who won the competition last year, is not here. Who do we look for this year?
Well, Bev actually sort of walked away with it last year because she combined both muscularity and femininity and shape. This year, it's going to be a little bit closer because in my eyes, there's about five people that will be top contenders. Three from the United States, Janice Reagan, Kathy Palio, Donna Oliveira. We've got somebody from France, country person, Dominique Dardet, and somebody from Finland, Mario Salin. And it seems that they're going to have a hard time judging between the taller, more slender physique versus the shorter, stockier, more muscled physique.
All right, it should be an exciting competition. Let's go to it.
All right, Corey, you mentioned Dominique Dardet. She's our first competitor. She's the hometown favorite. She's a former French world bodybuilding champion. She's 30 years old.
You can sure hear that she's the hometown favorite. Just listen to the audience. They're going nuts over her.
Well, how important is the crowd response to the judging?
None. I mean, the crowd does not influence the judges. The judges are judging on symmetry, proportion, muscular definition. And let me add at this point, too, if you look at Dominique's shape, she not only has a lot of muscle, but it's very extremely chiseled, meaning she has a low percentage of body fat. So she's in fantastic condition in this contest.
And her symmetry?
Her symmetry, I think that she's got okay symmetry. Her legs are a little bit long and her back is a little bit short. And I think that this is why Dominique is always sort of a swing person. She may score third place in one contest and 16th in the next because they just don't know how to place her.
Because of her body type.
Yeah, because of her body type and because of her very well-conditioned physique, she confuses the judges. Once again, her back is a little bit short, her legs are a little bit long. She can't do anything about this. This is just her genetics.
She seems to have a tremendous presence on stage.
She does. She's been competing for a long time. She's got actually very beautiful muscles in that they're very long and lean. And she's got a tremendous amount of enthusiasm both on stage and behind stage. She's one of the most friendly competitors I've ever met.
In order to be a successful bodybuilder, I guess you got to have a little showbiz in you also.
Definitely. You have to really be able to flaunt your stuff on stage. Even if you're a shy person, you still have to be able to get up on stage and show what you've worked so hard for.
What would be her strong points?
Her strong points are her degree of muscular definition, which is obtained by a lot of hard training and a lot of hard dieting. So she's done her homework in both of those categories. Her arms, her shoulders, and her back are tremendous.
Her performance, in your opinion, Cora?
It's fantastic. If I were her, I'd cut my hair or pin it up a little bit so that you don't see this big ball of hair. It takes away from the physique. But I think she'll be up in the top five. She's in tremendous shape, the best shape I've ever seen her in.
Well, we have had some
controversy
here. Two of the girls have failed the mandatory drug testing, one of which was Juliette Bergman, a past champion. She was the 1986 world champion.
In the sport of bodybuilding, we test for a series of different drugs that are banned. Those are anabolic steroids, anti-estrogens, diuretics, and probenecid, which is considered a blocking agent. When the athlete is found to have these drugs in their system, they are disqualified. At this particular world championship, 2 out of the 27 athletes were disqualified for anabolic steroids.
The Europeans are, I'd say, trying to head into a much more muscular position than us. Plus, we are really, it seems like it's always the Americans who try to stick to the drug free, and then we pay for it. Look at our men. Our amateur championships have dropped back because we're trying to fit in and to do what we're supposed to do with the drug testing. Then you get over to the European Opens and stuff like that, and you get sat on your butt.
As we look at our next competitor, 22-year-old Tanya Knight's routine, Corey, your reaction to this steroid issue?
Well, on behalf of women athletes, we all want drug testing. We want random drug testing and drug testing, which includes diuretics and every banned substance. But we also want the men to have drug testing, too.
Well, that sounds fair enough to me. Now, Tanya Knight, right off the bat, we see a different body type.
A completely different body type. As you see, Tanya Knight is smoother, meaning she's got a little bit more body fat covering her muscles, which is natural. Women have more body fat. Dominique Dardet was much more defined and chiseled and trained down to a contest stage. I think Tanya could have come in about 5 to 10 pounds leaner to show more musculature. Her strong points are her beautiful symmetry and proportion. She has beautiful lines, as you can see here.
Another obvious difference is her routine, a lot more movement.
Yeah, now that's not necessarily good or bad. You can be a champion with a slow routine, you can be a champion with a fast routine. I've used both types of routines. Thing is, you have to make sure you hold your poses long enough so that the judges can see your physique. I think her music is a little bit choppy, though. It keeps changing, like here it just changed again. This does not allow the judges and the audience to fall into a certain mood which she's trying to develop because she changes the music too quickly. She really does have a beautiful physique, a lot of potential there.
Tanya Knight, 22 years old, originally from Kansas City, Missouri, now living in Venice, California. Now, when we come back, Canada's version of the Twin Towers. Kathy Palio, 29 years old, from Santa Rosa, California, 1988 overall Miss International champion.
Yeah, she just won that title 2 weeks ago. Therefore, she feels very relaxed coming into this contest. She wants to come in and just have a good time. She's qualified for the Miss Olympia, so this is just going to be a lot of fun for her.
Very fitting music for this lady with the tremendous body type.
She loves posing. She's a fantastic competitor, and she's a real fighter, too. She's a fighter in the gym, and she's a fighter on stage. She's very, very feisty.
Now, there's a lot of movement to her routine also, a lot of dance steps.
Yeah, women and bodybuilders are starting to get more and more into dance motion. Although you see she's hitting dance motions, but she's still hitting a lot of muscle poses. So she's combining them both very carefully. Women's posing is now influencing the men's posing. You're seeing more and more men getting higher energy, more novel type poses in their posing routine too.
I really think the dance aspect enhances bodybuilding tremendously.
Yeah, that's a very good point because the audience only sees dance motion in the evening performance. The morning performance, which is called prejudging, is a series of about 4 to 5 hours of very vigorous comparisons in both symmetry and in muscularity rounds.
A very strong performance by Kathy Palio from Santa Rosa, California. Now we move from bodybuilding to city buildings. Now, I live in New York, and anytime you fly over New York, it's hard to miss the Twin Towers. But who knows which one's which? People here in Nice have been confused all week about these Parmalee girls. Now, I'm not confused and never have been confused. This is Gail, and this is Sandy, right?
You guys have
a gymnastic background that you've brought to bodybuilding. How was that transition made?
Pretty smoothly.
Very easily, actually, because a lot of the movements and exercises that we use in gymnastics are similar to bodybuilding.
Exactly, actually.
You were telling me about something that happened on the judges' stand when you were doing...
Sandy was slated to win a major provincial competition. Well, they told me ahead of time my score, so I added them up ahead, you know, of the computer, and I got it, I beat her, and turned out that I miscalculated, trophy waiting to go up, and they called Gail's name, and I went, no, this is wrong. And I beat her by a tenth of or a hundredth of a point, and she just wound up and bopped me in the nose right on the podium.
It's so confusing that I keep turning around and seeing the same person, but you're Gail and you're Sandy.
No.
I knew, I was just kidding. You're Gail and you're Sandy.
Yeah.
I can imagine what a judge might go through.
Now, this being your first professional competition, I would imagine that you'd be nervous. Sandy, are you nervous?
No, I'm not nervous. I'm Gail.
I knew she was Gail.
Yeah, sure you did.
And this is Sandy.
Good for you. There's only two to pick from.
Now, she does it a little bit different here. She adds some gymnastics into her routine.
She does, and I think that it really adds something to the sport of bodybuilding, because she's not just doing gymnastics just to do gymnastics. Like here, she's doing a gymnastics move, but it's showing a lot of muscularity. So she's not just throwing in gymnastics to show that she's a very agile, coordinated person. She's using it for the purpose of bodybuilding.
This is her sister looking on. It's apparent that I don't know which...
That's Gail.
I know now. And that's Sandy, once again.
You can see that Sandy's very, very comfortable on stage. It's her second home.
A very exciting and interesting routine by Sandy Parmalee of Vancouver, Canada. One of two people that's causing all this confusion here. Coming up from Nice, Mario Celine, Donna Oliveira, and Janice Reagan. Three women that I have no trouble telling which is which or who is who.
Maude, here's Mario Celine, a beautiful model, bodybuilder, and student. I asked her about her attitude towards the sport.
And it's a lifestyle. It's not just a sport. Like for me and my husband Hanno, we are going to be bodybuilders for the rest of our lives. It's really deep inside of us. You know, we like training, we like healthy foods. We like feeling good about ourselves, and even if I stop competing and Hanno never competes anymore, whatever, we'll always be what I call true bodybuilders.
Mario Celine, 1981 Finnish champion. She now lives in Washington, D.C.
She's also finishing up her business administration degree and also studying German.
A well-rounded bodybuilder.
Yeah, last year she got sixth place in the Women's Olympia. And since then, I think she's added about 10 pounds of either muscle or fluid, and she actually looks much, much better at this body weight. She was a little bit gaunt and thin at the Miss Olympia versus here. Mario is one of the athletes who has competed in every single pro show since 1983. And every single Miss Olympia since 1982. She's competed in 12 pro shows, and I've only competed in 4.
Corey, a very sensuous routine.
She's really sticking to her style. From day one, she's had this type of posing, very sensual, slow, rhythmic type movements. People have always suggested to her, Mario, why don't you pose faster? Why don't you jump around on stage? But she's her own person, and she's going to stand by what she does best, and this is what she does best. You also notice with Mario's physique, she's got beautiful symmetry, meaning her arms are in proper length to her legs, her upper body is in proper proportion and symmetry to her lower body. She's got fantastic symmetry, and I think she could very easily win this overall title.
Well, she certainly puts to rest the myth that bodybuilding destroys your femininity.
And Ahmad, I couldn't agree with you more.
Mario Celine, 27 years old, from Finland, residing in Washington, D.C.
Mario Celine.
Next up, Donna Oliveira, certainly one of the favorites here. She's made a drastic change in her training routine. Corey spoke with her earlier.
All we know is my sixth year now competing, and my body just was not reacting to any of the training. I was just going downhill instead of getting better, and I know what my potential is, and it just wasn't showing up. So I took a whole year and a half. I got married, living in Michigan now, and loving it.
Still
training hard. Yeah, I'm a registered nurse. I work in an emergency room, and I work with hospice patients.
That's
so
fantastic.
Yeah, and I really enjoy it.
Donna Oliveira, registered nurse, and a very beautifully built one. 28 years old, she was the 1985 overall USA Women's Champion, and also the 1985 World Games Champion.
She also won the 1985 Couples Championships in the USA. Donna has seemed to add some size to her upper body, mostly in her back and her arms, and also in her calves. So she's improved from 1985.
Also a multi-dimensional person.
This is true. Along with Mario Celine and many other bodybuilders, these people also have regular jobs where they work full-time. And what it boils down to is the degree of discipline that these athletes have and commitment to training and proper dieting.
Well, Corey, her routine is just fantastic. She seems to be so smooth, so confident, and extremely cut.
But you know something? She is so nervous. She is not confident. She's nervous because she's in such good shape, and everybody's saying, oh, Donna, you can win this show, you can win this show. And she's a very meek, mild person. And this is something that she's exuding this confidence, but really she's not.
Once again, the showbiz aspect of bodybuilding.
That's for sure. She is confident in that she finally took her own body and dug deep down inside and trained the way she knew she had to win a title instead of listening to all the gym rats saying, do this, don't do this. She's doing her own thing, and this is why her body is back to the Donna Oliveira of 1985. She's very short, very petite, very slight. She's maybe 5 feet tall.
And very muscular, I might add.
Sure, I would have her as a nurse any day.
Donna Oliveira, a registered nurse who lives in Michigan, and seems to be back on track. Coming up next is Janice Reagan, 30 years old, from Los Angeles, California, former Missouri State Champion, 1983, U.S. National Champion, 1984, middleweight division. She's also a consultant for a vitamin company.
She also got seventh place in the Miss Olympia last year, too.
Now, she's extremely cut.
She is so cute, too. She's a little Mary Tyler Moore. She's very defined. I think she... pound for pound, she's got more muscle than anybody on stage today. And she's also a very small individual.
And once again, you see tremendous stage presence because she really looks like she's enjoying herself.
And let me tell you, her stage presence has improved tremendously in the last 3 years. She's gone from being much more shy and held back on stage to now she's just a little dynamo. She's fantastic. A lot of energy in her posing routine.
I noticed a lot of the girls are doing a lot of the posing on the ground.
Yeah, that's just another technique. I usually don't like going on the ground because of the angle of the judges. They can hardly see you if you're doing a lot of posing on the ground. My philosophy is to be tall and elegant and long, but yet you need to change levels from up to down. It adds to the overall performance. See how much muscle this girl has?
And not so much dance routine as the earlier girl.
No. Her strong points are her muscularity. And she's got really good shape, and she's flaunting that.
And it's her flaunting that this French crowd appreciates. Janice Reagan from Los Angeles, California.
Janice has the best back and shoulders in this entire lineup. And with that, she's going to be a big contender for the title.
Excellent routine. Corey's with her now.
You just got off stage. I know you're tired, but a lot of people out there rooting for you. A lot of people think that right now that it's between you and Donna Oliveira. How do you feel?
I think it is, too. I really don't know, and you really never know to the end. But I think I've got just as good of a chance as anyone. So, and I know I've worked very hard for it. I hope I get it, but I hope the best person gets it.
I'm in Nice, France, where the judges have already selected Tanya Knight, Donna Oliveira, and Mario Celine as three of the finalists.
No surprises yet.
Janice Reagan is the fourth finalist. And Kathy Palio is the fifth finalist.
Oh, very disappointed Dominique Dardet. You know, I'm equally disappointed. I'm so surprised she's not in there.
Again. Pose down again.
I thought for sure she'd be up there.
It appeared that she thought she'd be up there too, but she didn't make it. These are our five finalists. And is this is where you seal your victory, I would imagine.
This is a chance for the judges to see you one last time on stage with all of the other top five finalists where they can give you another assessment. If it's very very close. If it's a tie, this is the time when the judges will score to break a tie.
Is it possible here to sometimes lose your confidence in the pose down?
Definitely. A lot of people who are newcomers, okay, Mario Celine, she jumps immediately down. She's been in a lot of contests. She knows exactly what to do to draw the attention to her. There's Jim Mannion, the head judge, the best judge in the world, watching.
The one with the smile on his face.
Yeah. He's always smiling. You got a judge, Julian Feinstein from England. Now notice how small Donna Oliveira is compared to these other girls. She's just a little mighty mite up there. Mario Celine being the tallest, along with Tanya Knight.
I noticed Tanya's standing off by herself, not really comparing herself to the other ladies.
No, she's just trying to draw all the attention to herself. If she's in the middle of this mob, less people will be looking at her. Mario Celine has a perfect position, but she's right in the middle underneath the light.
Mario may have a perfect position, but it appears that Donna has a perfect physique.
Right, I don't know, Ahmad. I think they all have pretty perfect physiques. I'm going to stand by my guns, and I still think it's between Kathy, Mario, and Donna.
As they pose right to the end.
Yeah, there's their petulant smile pose.
But our judges are ready. I imagine this is a very tense moment for all five of these ladies.
It's incredibly tense.
Sonia Knight, fifth place.
Now that's a very good position for her to be in, being in her very first professional show.
Ce soir à ce championnat du monde féminin.
Tanya Knight takes fifth. Fourth place, Kathy Palio, who competed in this competition just for fun. She goes home with a check.
For the third place tonight, Mario Celine.
Mario Celine, third place, and you have been right so far.
I think that these three girls, any one of them could have won.
Janice Reagan.
Janice Reagan is the runner-up, which means Donna Oliveira is our new champion.
And did you see the surprise on her face?
Donna Oliveira.
She came into this contest just trying to show everybody that she can get back into shape. And look what she did. She won the whole thing, the overall title.
2-year layoff. I think this is the crowning glory to that.
Look at, does she laugh or cry?
Right, Troy, we have a new champion, Donna Oliveira, and that's one of the names that you picked at the top of the show.
Yeah, I love her physique. She's got beautiful symmetry and proportion. She's got nice feminine muscle. She has a great total package, and she is a little dynamo.
She definitely has arrived in the sport of women's bodybuilding.
Yeah, she's been here before, and she's here to stay this time.
All right, for Corey Everson from Nice, France, I'm Ahmad Rashad saying so long.